Creating a 5-year plan, a 10-year plan, a 20-year plan, being flexible, and putting feelers out there for opportunities. Feelers for your goals. Hello, y'all. I'm Diana Brienne. You know, a lot of people say, well, I just don't know what to do. I don't know what I'm going to do. I have no idea. Well, first of all, I think it's important to have a plan, whether it's a 1-day plan, a 5-day plan, a 5-year plan, a 10-year plan, a 20-year plan. I believe in plans, and I believe that plans need to be flexible. And I believe that it's very, very important to pursue our plans. You know, you can have a great plan, but if you don't pursue that plan or if you don't put action behind it, likely not a lot's going to happen. And part of that action can be in putting feelers out there, adding feelers to things. You know, like, for example, if you want a job, but you're not quite sure which job or where to go, you start putting applications in a lot of different places that you think you might want to work at. And then you maybe get an interview or a couple interviews or several interviews, and then you get a better understanding of what's available and what you like. So you begin to put those feelers out there towards what you want. I talk a lot about 5-year plans, 10-year plans, and I always say keep them flexible, because often opportunities come along that we didn't think of, often new ideas, new dreams, new visions, new goals. It can come along and change everything, or even problems can come along and change our life a little bit. And so when things happen that are, you know, that are out of our control, sometimes we have to adjust our plans. And I got that. I believe in living fully in the present moment. I live in today. I embrace today. I never forfeit today for tomorrow or tomorrow for today. I keep them all in balance. And so I fully live and embrace my life today as it is. And I remember I take one day at a time in life. And yet I like to have a goal. I like to have visions. I like to have plans for my life. I don't want to be like a little boat out in the middle of the ocean saying, I don't know where I'm going. I'll just float around. Well, likely I'm going to keep floating around in that circle. I want to have a plan and a direction, even if I don't make it there. At least I'm probably further along than I would be if I didn't have a plan. So I believe in having, for me, I have a 5-year plan, a 10-year plan, a 20-year plan. Whether they ever come to manifest themselves or not, I still have them in place, because I think for me, it's the right thing to do. Like I said, I don't give advice. I don't give suggestions. I just share with you my opinion on life, as is with this one. But I think sometimes putting feelers out there is a really good thing, because putting feelers out there gives us a more of a knowledge of what is available out there and what might be right or not right for ourselves. And also, often opportunities will come that we didn't expect because we did put feelers out there. And I also believe in creating plans for our life. Whether they end up manifesting or not manifesting, it's better for me to have a 5-year plan in different areas of my life. I break down each area of my life and I create a plan around it. And, you know, sometimes it works out, sometimes it doesn't, sometimes it changes, you know, and we never know what wonderful things can come along in life that can change our plans too, or keep them the same, or help us get to where we want to go. A lot of people don't have plans because, well, they're afraid if they create a plan, it may not work out. Well, at least a plan that doesn't work out is probably better than a plan that you didn't have at all, because usually you get further ahead with a good plan. Well, from my house to yours, may God bless you. I hope you like, share, subscribe to all 5 of my channels. Links are pinned to the top of the comment section below. If you connect with me, I will likely connect back with you with all 5 channels too. Hope to talk to you then. May God bless you. Bye-bye.
To relax.
any place to enjoy Grandma's Bridge.